Greetings, two-stroke fans. This is a series for those that don't know about the secrets of two-stroke expansion chambers. Have a look in the links up the top for the playlist and previous videos. Okay, we'll get right into it. Previous video, I broached on the subject of pipe diameters and how the pipe diameters are mostly related to the gas pressures, and calculating the actual gas pressures is extremely complex, and there are models used, and one of the most well known by Blair, and I've read through all the lines of code, and I can tell you the pathway to actually achieving all of these diameters. But he also tested all his models against many engines and came up with some basic empirical rule of thumb values that can be reliably used for the different types of engines and what to expect. Starting with the header pipe, the header pipe dimensions, the belly section, neutral chamber diameter in relationship to the rest, and the actual diameter of the outlet in relation to the rest. Now I'll just cover briefly the header pipe and tapered types of header pipes is in relationship to not just the port, but also the angles of the diffuser, because it's not included in the diffuser timing calculations, but what it does is it aids gas expansion and the movement of the compression wave. And if we've got a lack of angle in our port or a long port, we can get more expansion in the header. And likewise, if we've got a steep angle here on the diffuser, we can have a higher angle here to actually smooth the effect of the wave going over there, because it can actually break down due to shock waves at the wavefront from a steep change. So that aids that. And the empirical values given are anything between 1 to 3 degrees of taper. The neutral chamber is also in relationship to the gas values, again, complex, and I can go through that if you like, but I think we'll for basic purposes, we'll stick to the empirical values that Blair also gave, because they do come from those models, don't forget. The neutral chamber, again with gas, if we're working for peak power, we want a larger neutral chamber. If we're working for more broader power, we want a more narrow neutral chamber. Likewise with the tapers, a shallower taper gives us broader power, a steeper taper gives us a higher peak. So if we're working for peak power or working for broad power, we have a difference in not just the tapers, but also the diameters, okay? That's fairly intuitive, but the one that is not as intuitive is the outlet pipe size. And the outlet pipe cut size, the reason I got this picture again, is comes back to the port plugging effect. Aside from the baffle cone reflecting the port plugging as the exhaust port closes, that also, after a number of cycles, the gas builds up. That pressure also has a port plugging effect off the power and off the peak and outside of the timing of the baffle cone. So we have to be aware of that. Now, if we've got an engine where we're going for broad power and we haven't got a high gas peak pressure, then we need to back off the port plugging a bit, because if we have a strong port plugging effect and we don't have much gas and we're trying to use shallow tapers and whatnot to exploit more low end power and a broader power range, our port plugging could ruin that. So in the case of the outlet pipe, if we've got lower gas pressures for broader power, we have a slightly larger outlet pipe and a slightly smaller outlet pipe to give us a stronger port plugging effect if we've got high peak gas pressures. And the numbers for those given by Blair: header pipe, that's the diameter factor. So that's between the exhaust port diameter, which is exhaust port area converted into a round diameter figure. Neutral chamber ratio between the diameter, that's the multiplication factor. Broad power, 0.6 times outlet, 0.7 times broader power. There are values given for the header pipe angles by Graham Bell. These are in the 90s. I was into karting then a bit, and tinkered with expansion chambers a bit then, but my biggest time in expansion chambers was in the 80s. So I was working from the Jennings formulas back then. And these empirical values that Jennings gave, because he got all these from measuring pipes a lot, worked. So these are for road racing bikes, however, because in the 80s I was road racing two-stroke 350 twins. Wasn't everybody. The good old days. So I think that will do it for today. And what I will get on to, so that'll do it for today. I can get more into these complex modeling, but for now we'll just stick with the empirical values. So you've got those basic values, and as in the previous videos, if you measure up your expansion chamber, you can measure the diameters of the pipe, and you can measure the exhaust port area, and then there's a conversion factor to turn that into a diameter to work with the pipe ratio. And you can measure up the angles, measure up the lengths for the timing, and then you can measure up the diameters according to these figures. And you know, if your pipe diameters are within the ballpark here, that's good. But perhaps, you know, the outlet pipe might be a little bit too small or towards the large size, and you want to go the other way. You know, you don't want peak power, you want broader power, and the outlet pipe is a little bit narrow. Okay, if you have a narrow outlet pipe, you're going to have too much port plugging effect down low. You're going to knock off your low end power, and because you've got not much gas pressure anyway for peak, the baffle effect isn't going to work as well. So yeah, just a rough guide there. So you can measure your pipe and actually see how close they are, and that might point you to somewhere to being able to make modifications to it to pep things up a little bit. Okay, well that will do it for today. And hopefully we'll catch you in the next video. And if you have any questions, by all means, hit the comment section and ask. Don't mind answering anything. All right, bye for now.